Hi, let me walk you through the process of putting together the Giving Thanks journal. It is super easy. In my website, and you can find the link in the description box below, you will find the cover file and the inner pages file. And you need to print the cover file on a 4x6 piece of cardstock first. And what I do is to cut my cardstock to 4x6 before I print it, and then I insert the cardstock or the pattern paper the same way I would insert a 4x6 photo paper to my printer. You can also just send it to your favorite printing lab and not doing it at home. So I printed one cover page and I printed 6 inner pages. Now all these 6 pages come from one sheet of 12x12 patterned paper. And I thought it would be nicer to print it on the pattern, but you can also print it on regular white cardstock. And you can print the inner pages as many times as you want. You can give it to each of your family member to fill it in and then include the 4x6 picture of that family member just on the left side next to it, or you can just fill it in yourself and put a picture of the person or the thing that you want to give thanks for, and you can just collect pictures that represents what you are thankful and grateful for this Thanksgiving. In addition, you will need 2 cover pieces. Here I just chose one medium weight chipboard that I had lying around, and a piece of transparency, a 4x6 transparency that I just printed a pattern on. Here you can see that better, like that. And that would be my cover pages. Now, as you print the project pages, you will see this black punching guide, and I will soon show you what you are going to do with them. In addition, you will need a hole punch, a pencil or a pen, and 4 binding rings. It is super easy. First, take all the pages. You can do it all together or one by one, depending on the hole punch that you have. And then just align your hole punch with the center of the punching guide and punch through. Now repeat for all the 4 marks, all the 4 punching marks. Make sure after each punch that all the pages are aligned together, because they are tend to move around. And repeat, just centering the punching mark with the hole punch and punching away. And again, align all your pages together, center the punching mark with the hole punch and punch away. And lastly, do that again. Now, after you've punched all your punching mark, here is how to punch the chipboard part. Take any one of the pages that you've just punched, align it with the 4x6 chipboard piece, and with your pencil just mark the places where the holes are. After you've marked all your holes, repeat the same process of aligning the mark with your hole punch, and punching away. And again. Again. And again. Now, after all the inner pages as well as the cover pieces are punched, put them all together and bind with the binding rings. Just open them like so. Thread them through. You can also use ribbon. You don't need to use the rings. And of course, you can add more pictures, more pattern paper, and make it thicker as you please. Voilà. Thank you.